Hi everyone, welcome to World Visions Podcast, Usapang Makabata. I'm David Riaferio, World Visions Public Affairs Manager. Today we'll talk about the Student Ambassador Program of World Vision. Our guest is Zachi. Zachi, welcome to Usapang Makabata.
Hi everyone, my name is Zachi. I'm World Vision's Youth Ambassador. I'm a homeschooler and also part of the Philippine National Junior Team for Table Tennis.
Thank you, Zachi, for your time. Ang dami mong ginagawa, yet you still are encouraged to be part of World Vision. Ikwento mo naman sa amin, paano mo nakilala si World Vision?
Yeah, of course, I'd love to. So, I met World Vision, like, I guess it's been a while, actually. I first met them when I joined the SAP back in 2021, and that was still during the pandemic. So, during that time, I think that, like, I was really praying for an opportunity where I could, serve the Lord. Because, like, you know, during the pandemic time, like, you're not doing anything. And, like, your life is, like, on pause. So, yeah, I guess that's, like, what made me pray for that. And then, praise God, He really answered my prayer. And it was being, like, encouraged and among us homeschoolers to join the SAP. So, yeah, that's where I first met World Vision.
Mm-hmm. You said you've been homeschooled. Paano ba yung homeschooling? Do you still go to the school for a regular session or purely you're at home?
Actually, the reason why I homeschooled is because of my sport. So my schedule would be more flexible. And whenever I would go to international tournaments or even local ones, because I travel a lot, and homeschooling is such a big help. Like, if I don't have any trainings or tournaments, usually I'm just at home, or like sometimes in like, I go out with my tutor or my siblings to study together. So yeah.
Mm-hmm. So pag homeschool ka, ayun mo, you get to join tournaments, ano? So ibig sabihin, kahit paano, hawak mo yung oras mo? Or does it take so much discipline for you to be a good homeschooler?
I think it's like, you need to balance, kind of. Because, like, even if I'm abroad, like, I can't totally leave, like, all my schoolwork and put it on pause. I still have to, like, somewhat, like, bring my books with me and still, like, study, like, in between my free time. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Kasi I was trying to understand, so you're studying and then you're into sports and then nagkaroon ng opportunity na maging part ka ng World Vision. I'm thinking, ano ba dapat yung mga qualities or characters or interests basically ng isang estudyante na gusto maging part ng SAP? Ikaw halimbawa, ano ba yung pinaka okay sa'yo na gawin? Ano yung sabi nila, anong character, anong dapat na interests or values meron ng isang bata para maging part ng SAP?
I think number one is time management and commitment. Because, like, when you're committed to doing something, I think time management is really going to follow. And SAP, the program itself, it's 5 months long. So it's not a very, I think it's a just right time span for one student to be able to really join that. So yeah, like once you commit to it, I think it's really nice when you really get to balance with your school stuff, family stuff, and everything with it.
Yung SAP, 5 months siya, no? Paano yun? Daily ba na dapat meron kayo activities, engage kayo with World Vision, or meron lang regular times that you meet?
There are regular times you meet. Like, I remember we had like a few meetings in a month, like example 1 to 3 meetings, and then there are like projects we do as well per month, like example this month let's focus on 5K campaign, and then the next one, what since you completed that together with the other students, you're gonna do planning for an online event. Or, and then after that, next month, you're gonna do like a vision trip. So per month, there's like a task you're going to do, and you're going to really achieve that goal with the other students.
So kailangan talaga interested yung gawin niya, no? Limbawa, yung fundraising. And also doing vision trips, so you travel. Kailangan interested kang gawin talaga yon to really enjoy the SAP.
Right, I think so. Like, you have to really be interested, but I think before that, I think you need to have the heart also to like to really want it, to really want to learn more about the world vision and really like ask yourself like, oh, what is the purpose of me doing this? Like, because for me, like the youth talaga is like such a big thing. For me, I really believe in the youth because I think I've mentioned in previous interviews that I actually have five other siblings, so we're quite a big family. We're six siblings in total, so yeah.
Okay, vision trip. Ano bang ginagawa doon? Saan kayo nagpunta that time?
For mine, during that time, and it was during the pandemic, it was just a e-vision trip. And it was like, it didn't really have a specific place. Like, it was like really just generalized.
And then recently I saw that you joined us, you know, our team in delivering school kits to children. Can you tell us more about it?
Oh, yeah, that was so much fun. Like, honestly, it was my first time being like so close and intimate with the kids there. And can I say the place? Or like, it was in Baseco. So yeah, it was like a super, super priceless experience talaga. Like, the program started with some games and everything to like to hype up the children, and like I got to dance and play with them. They were all like so happy. They were also energetic and everything. It was really nice seeing the smile on their faces. Like, grabe, it's so priceless talaga. Like, it's once in a lifetime experience. And yeah, you can like really feel the joy radiating off them, and it just really encourages you. Like, wow, you can actually help out, and this is what the help goes into.
Nalala ko noon eh, pag maattend ako ng birthday parties, or maybe ikaw din, ano, di ba merong loot bags at the end of the party, yung
Yeah.
celebrate, yung celebrate and like to thank you, and then nagbibigay ng toys, and then you're super excited to see what's inside the bag, maybe candies or toys. So I think parang ganun din siguro yung nararamdaman nila, no? And this one is much bigger, and then mas maganda pa yung mga laman, tama ba? Parang ganun.
Right. There was like a few kids, because like you would just give them a backpack, right? There were a few kids who would like ask my help, like, oh, I want to wear it on me already. And like you can just see them, like they're like I would help them wear it, and they're like so proud of it and everything. Like you can see their backpack, and they're like showing it to their friends and everything. Like, oh my goodness, I have a backpack and everything. It's just wow, yeah.
So ano to, bali, I assume sa school mo, hindi lang naman ikaw yun nandoon. I mean, you have classmates. Do you tell this to them? Are they encouraged to also like join, or maybe, I don't know, share the stories on their social media?
Actually, we have a World Vision Club in school, and yeah. So World Vision is kind of like active also in homeschool, but I think like right now it's a bit inactive. But then, yeah, I hope that I get to really try to encourage them to be more active in the future.
Before World Vision, maybe before the pandemic, no, nung nakakalabas pa tayo, anong mga activities yung ginagawa mo aside from school and sports na related sa advocacy? Meron ba? Or wala pa, kasi bata ka pa masyado siguro that time.
Yeah, I think like the closest thing would be like just serving in church. Yeah,
Ah,
through
okay, yeah.
music.
How do you sing or you play the instrument?
I actually played the piano, but like I was such a small kid before.
Nice. Kasi iniisip ko parang what will it take a child dati, no, or a young teenager like you to join World Vision? Kasi maybe some would just want to, I don't know, to go out and play or do some online gaming. Pero ikaw, game ka na nag-join sa amin. And then, mainit, di ba? I mean, hindi naman, di ba, matirik yung araw. You go out with us, and then you spend your time helping other kids.
Yeah, actually, like I surprised myself as well, because out of all the people to like be part of this World Vision, actually before joining, I was like kind of unsure myself. I was like, do I have what it takes to be a part of this program? Because the World Vision is like such a big thing and everything. I'm like, I'm not even a big person. I'm not someone who can talk in front of so much people. Like I feel like I'm just a very young, small person during that time. When I joined the program, I think it really helped me with my confidence and my leadership skills. I think that's what they imparted to me when I joined. And really, like, I love how they really encourage the youth. Like, because a lot of people say nowadays, like, oh, you're still young, just enjoy your life, like whatever you do, like just wait until you're grown up to do something, to make a change, whatever. But actually, during the program, they taught us that us young people, we're given an opportunity to bless others. We don't have to wait until we're all grown up to do something. And we're also encouraged others, we are also called to encourage others to do the same, since we're enlightened about the situations in the Philippines. That's what we learned in the program. We can really share the word about it and make a change, especially now with social media, and that's what we use. And yeah, really, each action done, no matter how small, can really make a difference.
Doon sa mga activities na ginawa mo with World Vision, ano yung pinaka-memorable, whether it's online or face-to-face?
The Robinson supermarket buddy run. Yeah, that's like one of my ro most recent things also. And actually that was my second year already. Last year I joined as well with my sister, and also this year we did the 5 kilometers run. Yeah, that was fun and
Do you
tiring.
run?
My sport doesn't do much running, so it was like, even if it was just 5 kilometers, it was like a challenge for me. Like, I was really so exhausted after. It
Pero meron kang
was
medal
fun.
after, right? May medal.
So like this year they had like finisher medals for everyone. And
Nice.
the medals were really pretty. Yeah.
At saka may groceries din nakasama kasi Robinson siya.
Yeah, of course. Like,
Kaya
supermarket.
yung sport mo is ano, badminton or table tennis?
Table tennis po.
Table tennis. I see most of the time sa Reels, sa Facebook, no? Meron silang style eh. Akala mo, magda-drive sila. But then, biglang yung soft na touch lang pala sa ball, tapos hindi na mahahabol ng opponent.
It's called the drop shot. So
Drop shot.
basically, yeah, so basically you use that like tactic when your opponent is like far from the table. So when you like, oh, make it soft touch already, and they won't be able to get it anymore. So yeah, it's completely legal.
Oh, have you done that? Na-try mo na?
A few times, I think.
Mahirap ba yon? Kasi na sport ko din yan dati. Ano, I just love
Oh
the sport,
really?
but the sport didn't love me, ha?
Oh.
I was trying the, ano ba yung flight pa yun? They called it.
Domino, pendulum, chalk.
Anyway, Chop, I think, oo. Nasa malayong part na kayo ng table, and then you do drive.
Yeah, I'm actually a more close to the table player, but sometimes I do like kind of go far sometimes, like during rallies.
Ano mga countries na yung napuntahan mo to compete for this sport?
I've been to Thailand, Hong Kong, Laos, Malaysia, Singapore. Oh, and China. Yeah.
Sino pinakamagaling na competitor mo?
Oh, China.
Nahirap.
Definitely.
Talaga.
Definitely. Yeah.
And then, how is
They're
it like?
so
So,
good.
gaano katagal ang preparation for this?
For international tournaments, usually around 3 to 6 months, depending on the tournament.
And then the competition lasts for how many days?
It lasts a week usually.
Alam mo, may naisip ako. Maganda siguro, no? Kasi di ba we're thinking of the podcast later on, the child-led podcast. Maybe later on, pwede kayong magkaroon din ng mini tournament, ano? Like, you can organize
Oh.
it. Di ba? Kasi I'm sure a lot of kids will, of course, they'd like to maybe go on a clinic ng table tennis. But I'm sure meron din mga players dyan, di ba? Pwede niyong gawin yun. As,
Yeah,
again,
actually, I think like they've mentioned to me because for this year or next year, I'm not sure, but they plan to like have me have a day, one day where I'm gonna do like Bible distribution, and during that same day, like they want me to do like table tennis clinic, so like where I can like maybe like yeah, teach the kids who I'm giving the Bibles to like a bit of table tennis or something, like to bring them to a place, and when they're interested, maybe I could like have more lessons in the future. So yeah, I
I
think
be
like the first step is the clinic, and then like the mini tournament, I think that's like something I'm looking forward to as well, hopefully in the future.
Yeah, ideally, what resources will you need to put up a clinic? I mean, to set up,
I think
will one day be enough, or should it be a series?
I'm not exactly sure what their plans are yet, but then
But
I think
for
we'll start
you.
with I think we need to have like one day first to assess the kids and then see who are like really interested to pursue it, and then if like for sure some kids would really want to pursue the table tennis, but then some kids would want to try another sport or something, and from there, those kids who are interested, maybe we could have like future like sessions from that.
Ikaw, gaano katagal ka bago naging magaling na player ng table tennis?
Like how many years it took me to get like into the national team? I started when I was around 11. I'm
11.
17 now. I think got into the national team after 15. So around
Oh.
4 years.
So, ang
Yeah.
sport, is it a talent you're born with or natitrain siya or it's a combination?
Definitely not born with. Maybe some people
Oh.
are, but then for me, no. Like I'm super an indoor person talaga, and then like as a kid, like from my hobbies you can tell that I wasn't sporty. Like I would like just read books all day and just sit down and just be in the house all day. Like I wasn't like active at all. But it's my dad actually who's really like into sports, and he really encourages all of us. If my other siblings as well, they're all into sports, also all six of us, different sports. So yeah, he really encourages us. So when he introduced me, I did a bunch of other sports before pursuing table tennis. I did swimming, I did volleyball, but then I didn't really enjoy it so much. So then when I tried table tennis, I was like, oh, I think I like this. So yeah, I started training and then praise God, I excelled in it, and yeah, here I am.
Yeah, at saka for, for someone na hindi naman mahilig sa sports, sabi mo, no? But that was just 4 years before you became part of the national team. Magaling ka kasi, 'di ba? 4 years. Ako ilang years na hindi naman ako nakasali sa national team. So, yeah, praise God indeed for that, no? Sige nga, Zachi, for those who want to be part of the Student Ambassador Program, paano sila sasali? Saan sila pwedeng pumunta? And ano mga preparations yung mga dapat nilang gawin?
For the Student Ambassadorship program, actually, it's really easy. You just have to search it up, World Vision FAP, and it's going to lead you to the World Vision website. And yeah, that's where you can apply. I think it's studentambassadorship.worldvision.org, and then register. And it's really super easy to do so. And then it will tell you, like, when is the next batch and when can you start, and they'll give you all the details.
Okay. Any message to the kids you've met dito sa World Vision? Ano pang pwede naming abangan from you?
For the kids I've met, it was really so nice meeting you, and I hope to see you guys soon again, and I really hope you enjoyed when we danced and when we played together, and I really, really cherish our memories when they did the Bibles and when we distributed the back to school kits to you guys. And yeah, I hope to see you guys soon.
Thank you, friends, for joining us in Usapang Makabata. I leave you with this prayer from Joshua 1:9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Thank you again, Sachi.
Thank you again so much. Thanks for having me.
I'm David. God bless you.